हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी माहूर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर जूलॉजी, श्री सांवलिया जी गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज, मनफिया, चित्तौड़गढ़। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस पैरेंटल केयर इन एम्फीबियंस। व्हाट इज़ पैरेंटल केयर? पैरेंटल केयर इज़ द केयर ऑफ द एग्स और द यंग वंस अंटिल दे बिकम एबल टू प्रोटेक्ट देमसेल्व्स फ्रॉम द प्रीडेटर्स। इट इज़ अ very important phenomenon in amphibians, and the methods of caring which is done by amphibians generally fall into two broad categories, that is protection by the parents by means of construction of nest, nurseries or shelters, or direct caring or nursing by parents. So, first of all, we will discuss how parents protect their young ones or egg by means of construction of nest, nurseries or shelters. First of all, mud nest. They construct mud nest to protect their progeny. A large tree frog, that is Hyla faber, a Brazilian tree frog, it protects its progeny by building a basin-shaped nest or nursery in shallow water on the border of the pond. See, this is a mud nest in a shallow water. In that mud nest, you can see tadpoles. The female frog digs a hole of 8 to 10 centimeter depth, and the mud which comes out of it is used by the female hyla to construct a wall around the hole. This wall is raised about the level of water, and female hyla makes the inner surface of this nursery smooth, and even the female will lay egg in this nursery. The eggs and larval forms are protected inside this structure. The nest is 30 centimeter in diameter and 5 to 8 centimeter deep. Tadpoles hatch within this relatively safer barrier and develop until they are large enough to feed themselves. So it is all about mud nest. Then foam nest. Amphibians form this foam nest in holes near water. Rhacophorus silagelli. It secretes a jelly-like secretion with eggs from time to time, which is beaten by the crosswise movement of the hind limbs of the female partners only. And it results in the formation of small frothy mass. The mass of froth with egg is known as foam nest. See, this is foam nest. It's like a foam. Within few hours, the other surface hardens gradually and it remains in this condition for days together. There is one more example. The female of South America tree frog, that is the Leptodactylus mystacinus. It stirs up a frothy mass of mucus and fills it in a hole near water and lays egg in them. And the tadpoles developing in this improvised nest can readily enter water. So it's all about foam nest. Now then, tree nest. Means like these in a nest on trees and leaves. One very popular example is Rhacophorus malabaricus. It is also known as Chunam frog. It lays eggs on the branches of a tree which will be hanging over a pond. These larvae, after hatching from eggs, fall into the pond water and undergo metamorphosis and develops into tadpole. So there is one more example. a South American tree frog, that is a Phyllomedusa hypochondrilis. It lays eggs in the folded leaf nest with margins glued together by cloacal secretion. And when tadpoles are formed, fall straight into water below. So, young one develop relatively free from predators. Then, protection by transparent gelatinous bags. Salamandra caesarengli. It deposits its small eggs in a gelatinous bag which is attached to aquatic plant below the water level. Actually, Salamandra caesarengli is a small aquatic salamander. It deposits about 50 to 60 small eggs in a gelatinous bag. So, these are all mud nest, farm nest, tree nest and gelatinous bag is one of the methods of protection by the amphibian parent. Now, parental care by direct nursing by parent. First method is tadpole transfer from one place to another. Small South American frog, phyllobats and dendrobats, tropical African frog, antholeptes or pilobats, and colostatus. They lay their eggs on ground, and when the tadpoles are hatched, they adhere by their sucker-like leaves, lips and flattened abdomen to the back of one of their parent, and thus they are carried from one place to the another. See, this is example of colostatus. See, you can see there are some tadpoles adhere by their flattened abdomen to the back of frog. So this is the way by which tadpoles hatching out fasten themselves to the back of one of the parents with their sucker-like mouth and then transported to water. Now, second method is egg protection by male. The eggs in Mantophyrina robusta are strung together by elastic gelatinous envelope which form a clump over which the male sits for the development. Then, eggs carried by the parents. See, in elites called midwife toad, when the eggs are laid by the female frog, means the string of eggs round male's frog back and thigh. This is a male frog. When the eggs are ready to hatch, the male frog moves to a nearby a pond and the larvae are released. See, this is example of alite. You can see eggs attached to its back and thighs. Then female Rhacophorus reticulus, it carries the eggs glued to their belly. And one more example is Desmognathus fusca. The eggs are laid in the form of rosary like string, and this string is bound round its neck. See, and the female nourishes them at a comparatively dry spot. So female carries the string of eggs coiled around her neck until they have hatched. So this is how they carry eggs. Now, eggs in back pouches. In Brazilian frog, tree frog, Hyla goyli, the female carries the egg on the back within the incident brood pouch in which the eggs are remain exposed. See, this is a Hyla goyli. Here you can see eggs on the back. One more example, Nototrima. In Nototrima, eggs are placed over the back in a single large brood pouch, which is covered by skin. See, this is a Nototrima where you can see beneath the skin you can see eggs. So eggs are covered by the skin. Then another example, another thing is eggs in bag pouches, in cell-like pouches. See, in Pipa americana, which is also known as Suriname toad, the eggs are carried on the back of mother. See, in breeding season, the back skin of female becomes thick, vascular, soft and gelatinous, and the male places and spaces the eggs. Each egg sink into a small pouch over which develop an operculum. See, this is a Pipa americana. Here you can see eggs on the skin of, on the back skin of female. In the soft material tissue, here the eggs can develop into young one safely. Now, one more method, in the mouth or gular pouch. First of all, we will see by the male. In Rhinoderma Darwini, that is a small South American frog, the eggs are few but large, and they are transferred by the male to the relatively immense vocal sacs, which extend over its ventral surface and where the egg develops. See, this is a vocal sac, which is extending over its ventral surface. So here you can see eggs and their egg develop. So it's all about vocal, eggs in the vocal sacs. Now, by the female. The female of West African tree frog, that is a Hylam bats breviceps, it carries the eggs in her mouth. One more example, female Rheobatrachus cilias, it keeps her egg in her stomach, and the tadpoles are expelled through mouth after metamorphosis. Now, there is another method, which is eggs are coiling around the body. So you can see there is a female amphioma. It coils round the eggs laid in the burrow in damp soil. Then one more example, ichthyophis. It is oviparous. It lays eggs in burrow in damp soil and coil around them until they hatch. So they protect them directly. Then viviparity or viviparous amphibians. Some anurans are ovoviviparous. They retain egg in the oviduct and the female give birth to living young. There are some examples, Salamandra, the European alpine salamander. In it, the female keeps the egg in its uterus and it liberates only the young ones when are they completed their metamorphosis. One more example, the European salamander, Salamandra, it produces 20 or more small young, while the alpine salamander, that is S. etra, which give birth to one or two fully developed young ones. Viviparity is a widespread in order Gymnophiona of amphibia. So it's also a very common method. So we discussed all the methods. First, we see how amphibians protect their eggs or young ones by means of construction of nest, nursery or shelter. So we see four methods: mud nest, foam nest, tree nest and transparent gelatinous bags. Then we see how they protect by giving direct nursing. So we see how tadpoles are transported from one place to another by one of the parents. Then egg protection by male. Then eggs carried by the parents. Then eggs in bag pouches, which may be exposed, or in cell-like pouches. Then in the mouth or gular pouch by the male as well as by the female. Then how they protect their animal by coiling around eggs, and we also saw viviparity in amphibians. So it's all about parental care in amphibians. Significance is that by protecting eggs or young ones, they just protect their progeny from the predators. So it is very important method in amphibians. Thank you.